Hi, I'm Scott Backes, and I'm with Petzl, and I'm here today to talk about the ASAP and the ASAP lock. These are mobile fall arresters that are designed to accompany a climber either on a two-rope system or a one-rope system and provide a mobile fall arrest following them up and down the rope. They work pretty similarly, but their design is for two different usages. The ASAP lock is more appropriate for any situation where wind may affect the rope. And the ability of the device to lock the rope so that it can't slide down the rope while you're working, then to unlock it and have it self-trail is of great use anytime where wind is a factor when you're working. Both ASAPs work similarly. The rope is inserted into the device, and then the rope will follow the user up and down the rope. If a fall occurs, the device locks up. And to start the device again, you simply press the device, hold the rope, and lift up a little bit, and the device goes back into its up and down motion. If you're in a situation where it needs to be locked, there's the button that you would push. It says lock, you locked it down. Now it can't go down, but it can still go up. Not down, still up. Open the device, and you're back to being able to descend. The ASAP is activated by opening the cam, putting the rope in, letting the rope slide into that position, clipping in that absorber, and now clipping that into the user. And just like the lock, it follows the user up and down, but in case of a fall, the device locks up. These devices are designed to be used with absorbers. And what these absorbers do is they limit the amount of force put on the rope in case of a fall. One thing that's important to note is that all fall absorbers have a tech notice with them that talks about exactly how far this device will lengthen. When you're close to the ground, you need to be aware of how long the absorber will lengthen in the event of a fall. The ASAP absorbers come in two different lengths, 20 centimeters and 40 centimeters, and that gives the user the ability to be closer to the device or if work needs to be further away from the device. And both of the absorbers are designed with a force absorption based on how long they are. So even if you're above the device and you fall, the absorber will absorb that shock and keep the rope intact. When you insert the rope into the ASAP, make sure that when you clip in the ASAP absorber, it captures the rope. It has to go around the rope so that the rope cannot come out of the device. One other interesting feature with both the ASAP and the ASAP lock is the centrifugal force clutch. So what that means to the end user is that when you're on an angled surface, if you start sliding, the ASAP will catch you. And that's pretty rare. Most of the other devices don't do that. So while I'm on this surface and I start speeding up, we'll put it at an angle like this. And see how that caught? I didn't actually take a fall on it. I just sped up enough for the centrifugal force to stop the fall. A great benefit for people doing roofing work or any situation where they're on a planar surface that's angled.